present Haunted, Stories of the Supernatural. The Family by John Elliot, adapted for radio by Derek Hodinott.
Yes, sir?
Good morning. Detective Sergeant Forrester?
Yes, sir.
I'm David Eccleston, Mr. Watson's solicitor.
Oh, yes, sir. Come in, will you?
Thank you.
If you'd care to sit down for a moment, sir.
Thank you, but I'd like to see my client first, if you don't mind. Where is Mr. Watson?
In the bedroom. But before you go in, I think you ought to read this.
Oh? What is it?
A letter, sir, addressed to you.
So I see.
It hasn't been opened.
Oh, I can see that. Sergeant, Mr. Watson wants me to read it now, does he?
I think that's his intention, sir. When you've read it, perhaps then we can have a talk.
You're being somewhat mysterious, Sergeant.
I didn't mean to be. But perhaps when you've read the letter, sir.
Dear Mr. Eccleston, kindly forgive my presuming on your acquaintance, but I can think of no one else suitable, this being written in confidence. As you know, I'm a reserved sort of man. I don't make friends easily. You'll be surprised at hearing from me. In fact, I hope you remember me, since you must have to look after a lot of cases like mine. Having received full remission for good conduct, I've now been out of prison for some 18 months, and I'm still living in the city, as you can see from the above address. Although I'm a relatively well-educated man, as you know, I have not succeeded in obtaining good, regular employment. Once a thief, always a thief, I suppose. I'm not in trouble again. Let me make that perfectly clear. No. This letter is about something peculiar which has happened to me lately. It concerns a young woman called Carol Temple. I met her one night as I was approaching the front door of the boarding house where I live. Who's that? Who is it?
It's me. Only me.
Who is me? What are you doing here in the porch?
Nowhere else to go.
You're shivering. Were you going to stay here all night?
Yes. You live here?
I have a room, yes.
Oh.
Do you know what time it is?
No.
It's gone 1 o'clock in the morning.
I didn't think anyone else would be coming in. That's why I settled down for the night.
But you can't sleep out here.
Done it before.
What, here?
No. Other places.
My dear child.
Leave me alone.
I'm not going to hurt you.
Don't touch me.
Where do you live? You're from the country. Run away from home?
Maybe.
Alone in the city. No friends, no money either, I suppose. Look, you can't stay here. Not with that cough, you'll catch pneumonia. Come on.
What are you going to do?
There's my room. It's not much, but at least it's warm. And you can have something to eat. What do you say? So, you have no home, no parents, no relations. Is that right?
Yes.
Where are your belongings? Your things. You must have a suitcase or something. Clothes, personal things.
I left them.
Where?
Behind.
Behind? Where? At a station left luggage office, perhaps. In the country? Where?
Oh, stop going on at me. You sound like the police.
The police? Yes, that's where I should take you if I had any sense. I would if I... Look, Carol, why don't you go to the police? Tell them what you've told me. They'll help you find somewhere to go. They have contacts with people, organizations who assist young girls.
No!
But they'd help you.
No, please. Please don't make me go to the police.
Why? You haven't done anything wrong, have you?
No.
Is that the truth?
Yes. At I'd like to stay here. I like it here.
We could stay for tonight.
Thanks.
I'll sleep in here on the floor. You can have my bed. That cough really is bad. You need a doctor. You need to stay in bed for a few days.
Then let me stay. Please, Mr. Watson, let me stay. I won't be any trouble. I can talk to you. You're nice. You'd like me to stay. I know you would. You'd like a bit of company.
Carol, if I thought about you staying...
Oh, thank you.
Just a minute. I said, if I thought about it. I want you to answer my questions honestly and truthfully.
What do you want to know?
Well, you've told me nothing about yourself. You've been evasive in all your replies. Where do you come from?
A small village called New Hampton. It's in the West Country.
Why did you leave home?
Because I hated them and they hated me.
Who's them? Your parents?
My real father's dead. My mother and the man she lives with. They run a boarding kennels for dogs. I used to help them, but, well, they treated me like muck. No one else would work for them. I was forced to. So I decided to run away. I think they wanted it that way. That way they could be rid of me.
And that's the truth?
Yes.
I see. I'm afraid I haven't any suitable night clothes for you. Well, I could find you a shirt to put on if you like.
No, I don't want anything. Don't want to put you to any trouble.
There's a bathroom off the landing, to the right. You can't miss it. You'd better get to bed. It's through that door.
Thank you. And about staying...
No, we'll talk about it in the morning, Carol. Good night.
Good night.
Well, Mr. Eccleston, I want you to believe me when I say that I had no intention of taking advantage of this girl. But during the night, on that cold, hard floor, I not only felt uncomfortable, but I also felt an excitement. I don't mean excited sexually, but an excitement as if in a dream. I'd never had a naked girl in my rooms before. You may not believe it, but I've hardly experienced sex. No. What I felt most of all at that moment was a warm friendliness towards her. And soon I found myself in bed with her. She said nothing. Her body felt more developed and mature than I had expected. And then we made love. For the first time in my life. It was wonderful. But afterwards... I'm sorry. Carol. I shouldn't have. Did you hear what I said? I said I was sorry.
It doesn't matter.
Good morning.
Morning. I made you some coffee.
Oh, thanks. I thought I smelt it. Have you had anything to eat?
Oh, I had some toast. Hope you didn't mind.
No, of course not.
What's the matter?
No sugar.
Sorry.
You weren't to know. Well, what are you going to do?
Look around. I've decided to look around for something.
Good. Good. You can stay until you find a job if you like.
No. That's very nice of you, but... Well, I got a girlfriend who might put me up for a week or two. I'll phone her this morning.
I thought you didn't know anyone in London.
Well, there is this girl. She's not a friend, at least not a close friend. Only met her once. But I got her address and she might help me. I don't think you need to worry about me anymore. Honest.
I see. You better take this.
You can't afford...
I'm not broke. I can afford a couple of pounds, for heaven's sake.
Are you sure?
Yes, you take it. It's the least I can do.
Thank you.
After she washed up the breakfast things, she went. And I was alone again. There was no legitimate work that spring, though I assure you I tried. I did some more night work. Well, you know what I mean by that. And over Easter it was possible to do some daytime work, too, while people were away. Well, this is in the strictest confidence, of course. Because of this, I became a bit depressed. My whole life seemed a bit pointless, especially when I thought about Carol and our one night of intimacy. But I neither saw her or heard of her again. Until one evening, the 13th of April, the very anniversary to the day that you defended me in court, I arrived home late from a job.
Hello?
Carol.
That's me.
Are you all right?
Can I stay?
Of course.
Your coffee. I remembered to put sugar in it this time.
Oh, thanks. Oh, what have you been doing with yourself these last 3 months?
I got a job as a kennel maid at a place in Rickmansworth.
Oh, that's nice.
I didn't like it much, though.
Why?
People that ran it weren't friendly.
Well, why weren't they friendly?
Don't really know.
Had you done anything?
No. No, in the end, they told me to go.
Were they dissatisfied with your work?
Don't think so.
Well, they must have been if...
No. No, it wasn't that. I told them I was pregnant.
I see. Are you?
Yes.
How long?
Just under 3 months.
Oh, Carol.
Yes?
You can stay here as long as you like. I'll arrange it with the landlady. Hey, no. Don't cry. I'm going to look after you. We're going to be together. You don't have anything to worry about. Please.
You're so kind. And you've no reason to be.
Nonsense. But no buts.
Please, listen. The night you found me in the doorway...
Carol, I don't want to...
I want to tell you the truth. If I'm to stay, I want you to know the truth about me.
All right.
When you found me, I hadn't just arrived in London like I said. I'd run away. I'd run away from someone.
Someone? Who?
Someone. Doesn't matter. A man. What I said about leaving home and coming to London was true. But I was picked up by this man and I went to live with him. And then he put me into a house with some other girls and, well, he tried to make me like them.
A brothel? He turned you into a prostitute?
I told him I wanted to leave, that I wouldn't say anything. But he threatened me. Still, after a few weeks, I managed to get out one night. I was afraid to go to anyone, even the police. I'd never be safe from him, you see. That's when you found me. I was hiding from him. That's the truth. I thought you should know.
And that's why you changed your mind about staying? After we made love? You thought the same thing was happening?
Yes. Something like that.
Well, it does raise a question about the child, doesn't it?
I'm not saying it's yours.
No, I know you weren't, Carol. I know that.
You've asked me to stay, and I'd like to. But it'd be unfair on you to take on the responsibility of a child if it isn't yours. See what I mean?
Carol, can't you see? Don't you realize? I love you. What you've told me doesn't make the slightest difference. I love you. I loved you when I first saw you, and I love you now. I'd hoped beyond hope you'd return, and now... Well, I'm not going to let you out of my life again. And so it was. The next 6 months were the happiest of my life. We never discussed the baby much, not at first. She was content to do the shopping, look after our little flat. And I got regular daytime work now. She got plumper and she visited the clinic regularly. She made the arrangements with the hospital that when her labor pain started, I was to take her in right away because she was a bit narrow and small and it was her first child. That happened 4 days ago. You all right?
Yes.
They won't be long.
Carol? I'm all right. Another pain. It wasn't much.
I'll go and ask the nurse.
No. It'll be all right. Babies don't get born quickly like that, you know. Sit down, please.
They'll give you something for the pain.
When I need it, they will. I don't need it yet.
All right. I love you.
I love you.
Mrs. Watson?
Yes?
Would you come this way, please?
Reception? Yes, Mr. Lorimer. Yes, visiting hours are from 3 to 4 in the afternoon. Thank you. Goodbye.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I'm inquiring about Mrs. Watson. She was brought in last night.
Last night, you say?
That's right.
Emergency, was it?
No, not exactly. She's having a baby and... I was passing the hospital on my way to work this morning, and I thought I'd call in to see how...
There's no record here of a Mrs. Watson being admitted. Do you know the ward she was taken to?
No, I forgot to ask.
Watson. No person by that name. Do you know the name of the nurse who was on duty?
No.
Would you just wait a moment? Janet? Madge, reception here. I have a Mr. Watson. He claims he brought his wife in last night. Maternity. Yes. Just checking, Mr. Watson.
She's here. I know she is. We sat over there, waiting, and a nurse came
and... Keep calm, Mr. Watson. Probably a slip-up on the paperwork. It can happen. I'm on to maternity now, and they're checking the night's intake.
But she is here. She must be here.
Yes? No record of a Mrs. Watson.
Impossible.
3 intakes last night. Needham, Curry, and Patel. Thank you, Janet.
Look, I know this is the hospital.
Well, I was going to ask you that, Mr. Watson. Are you sure this was the hospital you came to last night?
Of course I'm sure. We sat over there. A nurse called my wife. We said goodbye, and she went down the corridor and into the lift. She must be somewhere. But perhaps she'd been taken to the wrong ward.
Highly unlikely. There's no record of her maternity, and there's no record on last night's log, a copy of which is left here.
I don't believe it. I must be going mad. You're saying my wife doesn't exist.
No, of course not.
I want to see the head man, please. Something's gone terribly wrong. I mean, who's above you? I have to speak to someone.
Mr. Watson, please try and calm down.
My wife is missing, disappeared. And you're saying... Oh, my God, I'm dreaming this. Please, God, get me someone in authority. Do you hear? Get me someone in authority! Well, Mr. Eccleston... They turned that hospital inside out. I called all the other hospitals in the area. They checked. No one could find Carol. I left my name and address. They said they'd notify the police. I dreaded going back to the flat. I'd be all alone again. But of course, I had to go home. As I walked, I found myself trembling. I got the keys out of my pocket. As I put the key into the lock, I thought I heard. I was sure I heard.
Carol?
Carol?
Carol? Are you there? Carol? Carol? Carol, you're here, aren't you? I know you're here. Carol? Carol, where are you?
Mr. Watson?
Yes, officer. What is it?
Sorry to get you up, sir, but I've been given to understand that you've been inquiring about a Miss Carol Temple.
Yes. Yes, come in, officer, please.
Thank you, sir.
Do you know where she is?
Well, sir, yes, in a manner of speaking, I do.
What do you mean?
You know she's deceased.
Deceased?
It's all right, sir. Take it easy. I'd sit down if I were you.
Thank you. She's dead, you say?
On Wednesday, April the 13th last.
Oh, that's impossible.
Well, I can remember it exactly. I've got my notes on it, sir. I'll read them to you, if I may. Between 6 and 7 p.m. at Marble Arch Central Line Station, a young female, identified by the contents of her handbag as Carol Yvonne Temple, threw herself from the westbound platform in front of an incoming train and was killed outright. The young lady was discovered at the post-mortem to be in a state of pregnancy, nearly 3 months advanced. There were numerous witnesses. Foul play is not suspected. The verdict was suicide while of unbalanced mind. I'm surprised you hadn't heard of it, sir.
What did you say, officer?
I said... never mind. All I can say, sir, is that you couldn't have been with the young lady last night at the hospital. You may have been the last person to see her alive on April the 13th. Sir? Well, that's all. I'd better go. I'll see myself out.
Oh, no. Not again. Please. Not again.
I have not been out since. I shut the bedroom door because I can hear the baby crying in there, and I imagine Carol in there with it. I got dressed after the constable left, though I've not yet shaved. I cooked myself some dinner yesterday and managed to eat it. All last night I sat trying to figure it out. It's all very quiet in here now. I hope you don't mind if I conclude this for the present, since I can hear the baby crying again, which I have to stop! I have to stop! I have to stop!
Well, Mr. Eccleston? Is it evidence?
No doubt about it, Sergeant.
Do you want to see him?
He's in the bedroom, you say?
Yes, sir.
How did he do it?
Don't know yet. Waiting for the doctor's report.
I see. No, I'll just make a note on the envelope, and you can give it to the coroner. The above unfinished letter was found addressed to me in the dead man's lodging.
That was The Family by John Elliott, starring George Cole as Watson. Carol was played by Janet Moore, the sergeant by Peter Baldwin, Eccleston by John Church, the nurse by Elizabeth Ryder, the receptionist by Jane Thompson, and the policeman by Graham Faulkner. Haunted is adapted and directed by Derek Hodinott.